What's up guys, welcome back once again to the Gaming Careers YouTube channel. Today's video we're going back to tutorials, you'll be glad to know, and we are looking at how to apply a filter or a lookup table within OBS or Streamlabs OBS for your webcam. Now, this might be the first time you've ever heard of lookup tables or filters, but I'm sure if you've used any app on your smartphone in the last 5 years, Instagram, Snapchat, even your camera, you're going to know about what filters are. They're basically ways of adjusting how a picture or a video looks by applying slightly different effects to the colors, and you can get some really cinematic and nice looking shots, and we're going to be doing that within OBS for your webcam. Now, probably one of the hardest things about creating these LUTs or filters is going and finding them on the internet, converting them into the right format, and then you apply it to your webcam, it doesn't look any good, so you go and try and find another one. I've taken that whole process out for you, and I have got 30 LUTs that you can download, and you can apply each one, find the one that suits you the best. I've tried to get a complete range so that it suits all kinds of webcams and environments. All you have to do is download and apply the LUTs, and that is what we're going to be looking at today in this video. Okay, so we're now at the computer, and as you can see, I've got OBS open. This exact same process applies to Streamlabs OBS. Maybe if I've got time at the end of the video, I'll also show that, but it's exactly the same because it's part of the core OBS functionality. So I have my webcam full screen, and I know that I'm going to get a comment on, you know, your webcam looks amazing, that's why these LUTs look amazing. Yes, that is true. I am using a proper camera connected to an Elgato Cam Link, but this process works exactly for any other video capture device. So if you've got a webcam or you've got a camera connected to something like a Cam Link, this will work just fine. Also, my advice as always, if you want to have a good looking shot with your webcam, is to have some lighting set up, but that's all for another video. For all intents and purposes, this is my webcam connected to OBS, and I've got it full screen. You might have yours in the bottom corner, you know, with your game in the background, but I just want to try and get this example through. So in the description of this video, I have a pack of the 30 LUTs that I have put together for you guys and converted to the right format for OBS to use. So if you head down to the description, click that, download the zip file, and save that somewhere on your computer. Once you do, you should have something like this saved somewhere on your computer. So you just need to extract that using, you know, 7-zip or, you know, any unzipping program. I'm just going to extract it here to this folder. And if you go into that folder, if I open it correctly, you should have these 30 LUTs, and they just kind of look like a grid of color. That's exactly what they should look like. They're PNGs, which is what OBS uses, and they've all got some funny names. I couldn't work out what to name each of these LUTs, so I just went on a website and randomly generated some surnames and used those. I don't know why, I couldn't think of anything inventive to call each one, because they all sort of do the same thing with different colors, so it's hard to come up with a name, so I've just given them surnames, which I think will work fine. So these are all PNGs that we're going to apply as a filter to OBS. So if we head back to OBS and we right click on our webcam or our camera source and head to filters, we should get this new box popping up. So what you want to do is you want to apply an effect filter. So if you come down here to the effect filters and click the plus icon, we should have one which is called apply LUT. So if we click that, we can name the LUT, let's just leave it as apply LUT, and then we get the option to browse to the path of the LUT that we want to use, as well as set an amount. So let's go to our folder where we've just saved those LUTs. It'll by default open up OBS's LUT pack. It sort of has black and white, red isolated, like really basic ones. Let's just show as an example red isolated. So these are the five that come with OBS. If we take the red isolated one and apply it, you can see that it's sort of made a lot of the image black and white, and it sort of pulls out anything that is red or kind of orangey colors. But we want to do one of the ones that we've just got from our pack. So if you head to the folder where you extracted it and choose any of them, I would probably suggest starting with the first one and going through all 30 and finding the one that you think looks best for your image and your background. For my purposes, let's go with Swanson. So if we click apply, you can instantly see the change that that has had. I'm going to move this over so you can see it in full screen, and I'm going to toggle apply and taking it on and off, and you can see how much difference that is making. It's sort of, it's darkening a lot of the highlights, and it's making the whole image, I think, look a lot more professional and sort of cinematic. So as I've said, 30 LUTs in here, go and find one that you think looks kind of okay. What I have done is I've kind of created the LUTs to be a bit overpowering, because you can actually turn down the amount that you want the LUT to apply within OBS. So some of them might really change your image quite a lot, but I kind of intended for people to be able to turn them down to a level that they think looks reasonable. This one actually looks quite good, fairly high, so I'm going to leave it at 0.9, which means it's applying 90% of the LUT through the image, and then you just click close, and that is it now. My webcam source has this LUT applied to it. And it really is as simple as that. It's the exact same process in Streamlabs OBS. You just right click on your video source, add the filter, and it's called a LUT. You just find the LUT, apply it, choose how much you want to apply, and click OK. So it's the exact same process. I don't think you'll have any trouble following this tutorial and using it in Streamlabs OBS. Let me know which LUT you guys like the most. Obviously, I've named them separately so that you guys can tell me which one you're using. I want to know which one of these 30 is the most popular and which looks good in your background. So if you have followed this tutorial and you're using one of the LUTs that I have provided for you, do send me a tweet with a screenshot of, you know, your webcam with the LUT applied, and let me know which LUT that is. I'd love to see how many people are using these and which one is the most popular. If you guys would like to see how to create your own custom LUT using Photoshop or some similar photo editing software, then let me know down in the comments, because obviously I've gone through that process a bit for this video. So if you have enjoyed this video and you want to learn how to make your own LUT and apply your own sort of colors and filters, let me know down in the comments, and that's definitely a video that I will do with you guys in the future. If you have found this video helpful and you may be using one of the LUT packs that we created in this video, please do give it a thumbs up. And if you haven't yet subscribed, what are you doing? This whole channel is built around tips like this for live streaming, for content creation within the gaming niche. So check out the rest of the channel, get subscribed if you haven't already. A massive thank you to the patrons this month. These people help create this content by supporting me monthly. So massive thanks to everybody here who has been supporting the channel. And if you haven't yet checked out the Patreon page, do head across to patreon.com/gamingcareers. Check out some of the perks that we offer in terms of live stream promotion, as well as, you know, tips and advice. Or you can just donate as little as $1 and hang out within the Patreon channel in our Discord. That's it for today, and I will see you guys in the next video. Peace.